Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So welcome to my new declutter series. I'm doing this intro for every single declutter because last time I didn't have an intro and it felt really weird. I hope you enjoy the video. You'll know what I'm decluttering down below. Give it a thumbs up if you like these type of videos and I'll see you soon. This is going to be probably one of the biggest drawers that I'll be decluttering, and that is blushes, highlighters, and bronzers. I'll just start with like the newest ones. Hopefully everything doesn't roll away. So these are the Almay Make Them Jelly Highlight. They probably don't look pretty right now because they've been sitting sideways. Like, isn't that gorgeous? Like, it's beautiful. They're very smooth and just like pretty, but very sparkly. And like, the glitters remind me of like the shine of like a ring or something. Like, it's so pretty. So I'm keeping both of those. And these were sent to me by Almay. So these Burt's Bees, I think I did a dedicated video to like all the Burt's Bees products, and I'm gonna keep this Sway Sands, the pink one. It's like a really pretty natural flush of color if I am looking sickly and I just, you know, don't want my mother to be worried about me, because every time I go to her house without any makeup on, she thinks I'm dying. This one's just, it's still very natural, but I'm not a huge fan of blush anyway, so I'd rather this go to someone that loves blush or someone with deeper skin that might enjoy a very natural look. This is the Olaglow highlighter, and this one I'm not gonna keep just because it doesn't do very much. Bronze Splash, it's like their bronzer version. So I might keep this, give it one last chance. It might be nice in the winter to make me look alive, but if not, then I'll eventually give it away. This is the Mega Glow Halo Liquid Highlighter from Wet n Wild. I am gonna get rid of this. As much as it's really pretty, I don't think I'm going to get any use out of it. And I'd rather it go to a home where people love liquid highlighters. As for blush, I'll let you know if a Wet n Wild product was purchased by myself. A lot of them were sent to me. This one is the Mega Glow blush makeup stick, and it's in the color Hustle and Glow. Really like this. It's like a corally orange type of tone. So I'll keep this. I didn't use it this summer, which is kind of sad, but I'm determined. Now this is tough. I don't need both. I have the Essence Strobing Highlighter stick, and then I have the Wet n Wild one. They're very similar, and I actually did a blog post where I compared the two. So I wrote down that the Essence one is my favorite because one swipe is enough to get the pigment I desire on my face. I feel like the Wet n Wild now is more pigmented. Am I going crazy? I might keep the Wet n Wild one just because it's newer. And this is When the Nude Strikes, so I'll keep that one for myself. And I guess I'll give away the Essence one. They're both great, and I think they'll both work for lighter skin tones. Blushes. I'm keeping these Essence ones. Let me see, actually. Do I need both? No, I'm keeping both. Love these too much. The Satin Touch blushes from Essence are amazing. Love them. I probably won't buy a blush for, like, years. Unless one of them breaks. This Makeup Forever Artist Face Color. It's very pretty. It's just not my thing anymore. And then my Milani Luminoso. I absolutely hate the packaging of Milani products, but the product is so good. I just wish they would make it thinner, but this part is so thin. Like, I really think it's time to rebrand and make a smaller packaging. I can't carry this safely in my makeup bag without putting it in a plastic baggie, and I don't want to waste plastic and, like, be terrible for the environment more than, like, I already am. So yeah, but I'm gonna keep it because I love it. And then this is the Wet n Wild Color Icon Baked Blush. While I really like it and it's like super unique and pretty, I'm not really doing like extravagant makeup looks anymore. It's a little dark for my skin tone for like a normal day to day, even if I did want to wear a sparkly blush. So I'll put that in my basket, but this will be better suited for someone with a deeper skin tone. This is the Hoola. This is the Butter Bronzer. Physician's Formula is also terrible. Like, they have similar packaging to Milani. This is the Sun Club by Essence. And this is my Too Faced Sweet Tea Bronzer. At this rate, I'm gonna keep them all. That's not so bad though. Four bronzers, like this one's running out. This is a mini.
Who's the idiot that didn't check if their camera was still recording?
I am. So, I already have swatches on here. I'm just gonna run through what I've already done. So I wiped off my swatches for the Essence Pure Nude highlighters. I have the regular Be My Highlight. This is the one that Kathleen Lights has always raved about. Space Lighter, it's a pink one, it's Be My Space Light. And Cosmo Lighter, it's a green one, Be My Cosmo Light. Absolutely love them, they're amazing, very affordable. Love them, keeping them. And then Mary Luminizer, which I dropped, but I have put back together with alcohol. And I will repurchase once this breaks or I run out, which I'll never run out. So once it breaks completely and it's not fixable. So keeping that, it's my absolute favorite. And then I have my Almay, these are eyeshadows, and I did a whole review talking about these and I thought they were highlighters, but that's how I use them. So saying that I really like them both, I'm not too sure about them, so I'm setting them aside here. This is the ColourPop Flexitarian Highlight, and it's like super crazy bright. I would not use this as a highlighter. I'm a little petty about ColourPop because they gave me so much hell and terrible customer service. And long story short, we reported them to the BBB and they had to give us, they wouldn't give us a refund, so they had to give us a new product, which was this one. And yeah, I'm just salty because the customer service was so terrible and people rave about ColourPop and I really wanted to love them, but I hate bad customer service like that. So will I ever buy from them again? Only if they're in stores. And only if something seems so good that I just like can't handle it, but I will avoid buying from them. I'm gonna keep this as an inner corner highlight for my eyes. This is the Artist Couture highlight. This is so messy. I got this in a BoxyCharm. I no longer do just because it's a lot of money out of my entertainment budget a month. It was basic, almost half of my entertainment budget every month, but this is it swatched. This is another one that I will keep purely because it's so beautiful, but it's such a hassle. I will not reach for this to use like as a regular highlighter, but if I want a gold inner corner, this is what I will be using. And then I have my Wet n Wild highlighters. These are the Photo Focus. They're both in Precious Petals, 32-1B. As you can see on camera, they're a different color. Well, maybe you can't really see on camera. This one's more pink, this one's more gold. Like, the number at the back's the same. I'm not sure what's going on. I think they may have packaged this one by accident, because I know the Precious Petals is supposed to be pink. They even swatch very slightly differently. And these ones are very, very shiny reflective as well. I'm gonna get rid of the pink one, because I don't like the pink as much as I like the gold. And I'll keep the gold one. I love Wet n Wild. They're such great quality. And now, looking back at these, I'm gonna get rid of them both, give it to someone. They can use it as a highlighter if they want, or an eyeshadow, because that's what it's meant for, and I have not used these eyeshadows. The palettes. I got two drugstore and two high-end. Drugstore Revlon Photo Ready. This was sent to me by Revlon. This is the holographic palette. It has these four shades. I don't reach for this because I have another holographic palette that has all of these shades in it. This is a dupe for the high-end one, which is this Anastasia Moonchild highlight. So you can see. So this one was sent to me and I really like it. If I had known it was going to be this great beforehand, I would not have purchased the Anastasia because they are very similar and you don't need six shades. But I have both and I don't need both, and I'd rather a friend enjoy the drugstore one that I didn't buy myself. And I'll keep the Moonchild because I bought this one myself. It was very expensive. But this is amazing. So if you are looking for a colorful palette and you want a dupe for the Moonchild, 100% go for this one. This is the Nicole Guerrero Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. It has not existed for years and years, but this is my favorite summer palette. I like to wear these three darker shades, like on my body in the summer. So like on my clavicle, my décolletage, and like my shoulders. Like I just want to be super extra. That's what I'll do. I'll wear these three shades. And then like just on my face, I'll wear these three. This is the first highlighting palette I ever bought. Light Up Your Face Luminizer palette. Now this is kind of old and I barely reach for it. And like I really only enjoy these two shades in there, especially this middle one. But I have the other highlighters from Essence that I prefer over this thing, so I will be getting rid of this one, but I do love it. This one I was given for free. The Anastasia ones I bought myself. This is the Crown 12 color blush highlighting palette. I bought this at Generation Beauty. This has more tones that suit deeper skin, so I'll give this one to someone. This is the Essence Shape Your Face contouring palette. The blush is a bit too deep for me. This bronzer, it's too pigmented, so I like a bronzer, you saw, like very natural ones. And then this middle shade, it's just a bit too dusty to use under the eyes, but someone else might enjoy it, so I'll give that away. This is the Wet n Wild contouring palette. I gave this a really good review. It's not as practical as I would like. I'm honestly gonna reach for my regular setting powder, my RCMA like no color powder, if I just want to like set my under eyes. I'm too lazy to go for brightening and go for like one of my bronzers if I'm going to use this. So I'll give this to someone else. All right, controversial. So I bought this palette because I've heard amazing things about it. I absolutely love these two shades here. The yellow shade's almost gone. It was my absolute favorite. I'll keep using this palette until it's like it actually starts like breaking me out. So I'm keeping this because I've paid a lot of money for it and I do love it, but I won't be buying future Kat Von D products. If you have a banana shade, like the yellow shade, that is just as good quality or better, but just for the yellow shade. I don't want to buy a palette and waste money on it. I just want the yellow shade. Let me know. All right, that's it for my bronzers, highlighters,
and blushes.
I hope you enjoyed this declutter. Give it a thumbs up if you did. Subscribe if you want to see more or just watch any of my other videos. I have the playlist linked down below of all of my previous declutters, including this one. I'll see you soon with my next video. Bye!